Hi, I'm Kirsty, we came from Naio Nails, and in this video we are revisiting Marvel vs. DC, and the character today is Superman! Now we're going to move on to Superman! I'm gonna get my palette. Okay, so I'm gonna do same as I've done before. So I'm gonna do a bit of sketching first with some watered down white paint. I'm going to pull my image up of Superman. So I'm going to do it on an angle as well. I don't want to do the face sort of straight looking at you. I want to create a bit of interest. So that's why I'm doing it on angles. And also doing it on an angle will allow me to put more on. So I'll fit more of Superman on there. They've all got big traps, haven't they? They've all got big traps going on.
Explain what a trap is for people who don't know.
Traps are this muscle here. And I know that lots of men love having big traps. It's all about the traps. They need to like come from the neck out. They want big traps.
It's because they want to look like Superman.
Because they want to look like Superman. All the superheroes have big traps. So I've just sketched out his face here. So basically just mapped out the design. Now we're going to go with the skin colour using flesh tint. I want a little bit of brown to that. So I've got here burnt sienna. So I'm just putting one thin coat of this colour on. In the areas I need it. And we can start to put the rest of the colour on, so like his suit on his traps and his hair colour. So we need a bit of black. red and blue. Just picked up a little bit of that darker blue and brushed it over. His hair is going to be black. It's going to have some white highlights. I'm literally going to do all the borders of his hair and then fill that in. Fill that in. Second layer of the flesh colour. It's going to make it more dense, make the pigment more opaque. So, this is the first time that I've used flesh tint, because I didn't have it. And I have it now. So I used to have to mix one, whereas now I can just use it straight from the bottle. We've added a tiny bit of brown for Superman, but the other characters, I just used it straight from the bottle. It's a really good skin colour for doing any kind of portraits or anything like that. Just gonna use some of the red for his cape, that's just sneaking over his traps. Okay, now we can start to add detail, making sure my brush is completely clean. I'm gonna get a little bit of black, wash it down with some water. I don't want it to be too pigmented. Just gonna outline his super manly jaw. His ear. He has a little kiss curl. A bit like Michael Jackson. Sorry. Just adding a little bit of detail around his hair.
He's been flying around all day, it's a bit ruffled.
This, a bit ruffled there. I mean, I don't want it too neat. I don't want it too action man. Now I need to start putting the facial details in, which kind of scare me a little bit. Because you've got to get it right. If you don't get it right, it messes everything up. Oh God, I can't stop it now.
You've forgotten about the Power Rangers theme then.
Do you know what, when I sat down it came back in my head. I'm about to get it out and this is what I have now. Okay, so we have the eyebrows, the nose, the mouth. Now for the eyes, they are very close to the eyebrows. They're very little. It's like frowning. He needs a bit of Botox. Because he's frowning. He looks so strong. I'm just going to neaten these eyebrows up. I'm not going to make them like as neat as mine. I'm just going to neaten them up a little bit. So I'm going to do that by using the skin colour that we previously mixed. Now for a bit of shading and highlighting on the actual face. So I've taken burnt sienna, put quite a bit of water into it so you have a wash. This is going to bring a little bit of warmth to his face and also cast a bit of shadow. Now we're going to highlight, so we're going to take the white, some white paint, and some water. So I'm going to highlight parts of his nose. Don't forget when you're highlighting and shadowing, you need to think about where the light is coming from all the time. And make sure you pop it in the right place. So it's easier to do it on one side. So if you imagine the light's coming from this side, it's gonna look more realistic then. Just just got to highlight his hair a little bit. Tiny, tiny strokes, tiny amount of paint. Gonna give him some dark pupils now. That's him finished. I'm gonna seal it with top and base, and then because we haven't got his logo on this nail, because we'd need like a ginormous name.
Do you know what would be really cool?
What?
You had some kind of way of making him go between Clark Kent and Superman.
Well,
like with some like under that. UV or something.
Yeah.
If you went under UV, you'd turn into Clark Kent and then Superman. Sorry, I'm just being geeky now.
So because we haven't got his logo, I'm going to put his logo onto the little nail and cure that into the lamp now. I'm just going to wipe over that and take off a sticky layer. I can put a bit of oil onto this now. Now that one's finished. And now I'm going to pop his sign on here. And then on this, so these two nails are haven't got no design on really. So I'm going to put Superman on here. These are quite simple. Nice and easy to do. So I've picked the smallest nails for obvious reasons. It is going to be easier. So we're going to Superman first. Just make sure that nail's nice and clean. Wipe over with gel res. Instead of filling it all red and then going over with yellow, which would be harder to do, I'm going to fill it with yellow and then I can do the rest of the design in the red over the top of the yellow, because that will be a lot easier. Because if you do red, the yellow over the top won't be intense enough, if that makes sense. I'm going to do two coats of this. Because I don't want the blue showing through, because it'll change the colour of the yellow to green. While that's drying, I'm just going to give it a bit of a border with some black, watering it down because I want it nice and thin. With a coat of yellow. Don't worry about getting too close to the border because that part will be red. I've got some red. And I'm going around the outside of the yellow. Now we're going to do the S. We're going to break it down into sections. So we're going to start with the sort of end or beginning of the S, I would say it was actually. And then we're going to come round and do the first curve. Curving through the middle, start moving. Now we're going to add a border to it with some black paint, water it down because you want it to run really nice and clean. You don't want any thick lumpy paint. As soon as you see the brush is going dry, reload it again. So we've got the Superman logo there. Sexy Superman logo. Gonna seal that with top and base from the Urban Graffiti range. So I'm gonna remove the sticky layer now with some gel residue wipe off solution. I can finish that with a bit of cuticle oil now. What's the theme tune, Superman?
I was doing Indiana Jones, so I'm not doing Superman.